Everybody, welcome back to another episode of Falcon Plays Zafehouse Diaries. Two things I need to address before I continue the game here today. Number one, I appreciate the support. A lot of you guys seem to be really interested in this. This is going to be my second set of recordings for Zafehouse Diaries. The first four episodes of the series were recorded in the same day, so keep that in mind. So I do appreciate the fact, I might actually keep it around a bit because a lot of you seem to be rather interested in it, and I'm glad. I'm really happy for that, so thank you first and foremost for that. Second issue, we've been having a little bit of a tech issue when it comes to recordings. I'll show you what I mean. You know how I've been setting up tasks for individual people, right? So say something for make traps. If I would click this, you guys can't see this now, but there's a small little red drop-down menu that shows me the name of the individual along with a star system appointed to them. So basically one would be like, the person's terrible at the fucking task, and five stars means that they're amazing at it. You can't see this right now though, and it also applies to when I go into rumors. So say I want to spread a new rumor, you could see this now. But basically, there's another drop-down menu here for he wrote an article for a local paper, slightly, middle class, and middle-aged man. For all these four things, there's another drop-down menu you could choose. So right now, it says wrote an article for a local paper. If I was to switch this, I could switch this over to wrote a book. And I could also do directed a film. So you guys aren't getting the options and the star ratings for the people. Let me cancel this out because I'm not doing any rumors right now. So apparently this is an issue with a lot of Zafehouse Diaries Let's Plays because of how the game is actually programmed. So basically, recording software, at least the typical stuff like Fraps and DX Story, things to that degree, don't really capture that. What that means for us is that for this recording, I'm still going to keep doing this. I'm going to be a little bit more descriptive about when I choose my tasks, though, to give you guys a better feel. Because I understand how it could be annoying for you not to be able to see that. Believe me, it's annoying for me knowing that you guys can't see it because I'm the one over here trying to put the work into it, you know? So what I will do is, thankfully you guys pointed it out to me though, I'm going to try to find another recording software that hopefully does fix that problem. And more than likely I'm going to be looking at something like OBS or XSplit that does local recordings. So basically what those do is just do a screen capture of your actual screen. So the problem is I'm not doing that today because I do have to, number one, go and get those programs. I'm not sure if XSplit costs money. I've never looked into it. I know that OBS is free. I've messed around with OBS before, but I've never really gotten it to work properly. So I'm going to either figure out one of those two to do screen captures, and that hopefully should fix the issue. If it doesn't, then, you know, I guess we'll just probably wing it and I'll try to be more descriptive. But for now, it's not going to get fixed this episode and probably the few more because I'm going to do a few recordings today. But I will try to fix it as soon as possible, and hopefully switching over to another recorder does work. So hopefully you guys understand, and hopefully you guys aren't too upset about it. I will be more descriptive about the whole layout of things, how I do things, though, just for your benefit for now. But again, I apologize for that. It's something I didn't see happening, but apparently it's really common with a lot of Zafehouse Let's Play. So hopefully you guys understand. Now, all that shit aside, let's actually get into the game, though, right? That's what you guys want to see. Casey's over here, the... Casey was the ageist, right? So she hates old people. Well, luckily for her, Joel died, right? So I guess her hate's going to be a little bit spread a little thin now. Let me go into the things here. Isaac and Zachary, who apparently Zachary looks like, you know, Giancarlo Esposito over here. They don't seem to get along too much, but we'll see if we'll probably spread a rumor. I'm not sure yet. Maybe I will if it gets a little bit too bad, but for now I'm going to kind of roll with it. What are we looking at today, though? Well, I do believe that we got all the stuff from over here, if I remember correctly. This is our safe house right now. We've boarded it up, so it is secured. But there's a few zombies roaming about, and it's 2 a.m., so we're looking into night number 2 right now so far, because we got through the first one. So, what do I want to do for today? Well, Casey needs to be treated for injuries first and foremost, so let me see. Treat an injured survivor. All right, I'm going to click this over here, and you guys can't see it, but there's another drop-down menu for my four survivors. Zachary is apparently a 5 at treating injuries, so Zachary I'm going to choose right now, and he's going to be treating an injured survivor. He's going to be treating Cassie, so Cassie's going to be treated by Zachary, so Zachary's going to be busy for this round. Casey, I'm going to have her hang out for now in the base, so hopefully she gets a little bit treated right there. Now, we're going to have Isaac and Timothy left over here. So, what can we do right now? There's zombies here and here, but overall pretty good. So, I could continue making traps, maybe? Or are we good in traps? Let's find out how the area is set up here, secured. So, we have 11 of 12 traps, 2 of 2 outdoor traps, and 1 barricade and 28 furniture, huh? Alrighty, so what I'm going to do instead is we can make one more trap. I'll have Cassie work on that trap. I think she could still work. As long as she's in the base, then Zachary should be able to treat her. So we'll have her work on making some traps, even though she is injured. And then finally, Timothy over here is going to work on... Oh, man. I was going to do modify items, but ever since we lost Joel, only Zachary is good at it, but he's going to be busy treating people right now. So let's find out about barricading entrances quickly and loudly. We're going to switch to Timothy, and right here, this is another drop-down menu and quickly and loudly. Instead of that, we're going to be over to slowly and quietly for Timothy. Because, you know, there's a... He could probably start, hopefully, fortifying the base a bit. So that's going to be our task for this turn. Isaac is idle, actually, so Isaac does need something to do. Isaac isn't really good at making too many other things happen, though. He could create a distraction, but we don't want to attract attention right now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have Isaac... I'm going to have him watch for zombies for now. Or maybe even prepare a meal. How is there supplies for ingredients, by the way? Oh, we actually have some cooking ingredients now. So you know what, Isaac? Never mind. Don't watch zombies. Prepare a meal. You're not a great cook, but hey, it's something. All right, we'll do that. And that's good. Let's actually flip over time a bit here from 2 a.m. to 3 a.m. and we'll see what happens. All right, Zachary and Casey have been discussing tactics. They're both feeling smarter. Good. Good for them. Timothy ate a snack. A spike and cage trap has been set in the attic. It deals a high amount of damage and will make a zombie immobile. It has 4 uses. Cassie stopped making traps so she could be treated. A barricade blocking the living room was attacked, but it held firm. Isaac prepared a small meal. Timothy broke a lamp into 3 plastic barricades. The location is now fully trapped. Nice. Zachary treated Cassie's location with lacerations with a bandage. Cassie's concussion and broken right hand cannot be fully treated because the right medical supplies aren't available at the house. So in order to completely heal her, we're going to have to make ourselves over to the hospital over here. That has 24 zombies inside, so it's going to be a little bit of a task getting in there, and it's something that we can't do right now because it's the middle of the night. So if we do make it over there, it's going to have to be a little bit of a delay for now. So, Cassie, I know you have a broken hand. You just not have to tough it through. Just soldier that shit up, you know? Walk it off if you have to, even though it's your hand. So for this turn, we're going to be good because our security is going to be good. 12 of 12 traps, 2 of 2 outdoor traps. We have 3 barricades, furniture. Alrighty. So what would I like to do for this one? Well, we do know there's a zombie attacking the outside of the base, right? I think that more than likely, it looks like it's something that all 4 of my guys could kind of deal with this round. So how about everybody stop doing what you're doing? And we're going to go outside. Patrol outside. So here I'm going to do a drop-down menu. For patrol outside, I'm looking at Cassie at a 4, Zachary at a 2, Timothy at a 2, and Isaac at a 1. I'm going to assign everybody available. And right here it says patrol outside and report back. The report back option I can't switch, so I'm going to switch over to attack zombies instead. Again, this is part of the drop-down menu you can't see, so I'm going to try to be as descriptive as possible so you guys get the full gist of the things here. At least until I fix the whole recording issue. Alrighty, so there we go. We have that set up, and I am gonna just forward time, because we're gonna get rid of that zombie, because I don't want him, like, you know, I guess, drawing attention of other zombies here. So let's forward time a bit. Isaac ate a small meal. Timothy, Cassie, Zachary, and Isaac attacked a zombie while on patrol. They took care of them. Using a baseball bat, they struck down 3 of them. So 3 dudes were outside. We took care of them. Holy shit. Suddenly, there's a shit ton more around, so that's not too great. Should I even dare and actually have them go outside and try to clear up a bit more? If we do, I'm not sure. I mean, we have traps out there, right? I mean, our traps don't seem to be fucking doing what they're supposed to be doing, however. I don't know. That's a lot of X's, man. We have 1 here, another 1 there, 2 more here, and 2 more there. So we're looking at least 6 X's around us, which isn't something I'm too happy about right now. I'm going to go outside and try to have them check it out one more time. I know it's kind of risky, but I mean, if we clear up our area, we could at least kind of start moving towards the hospital in the daytime. Alrighty, Timothy, Zachary, and Isaac attacked a zombie while on patrol. They took care of them using 2 baseball bats, a hardened baseball bat, and a machete. They struck down 4 of them. Okay, that sounds good. What are we looking at now? There's 1, 2, 3, and 4. I feel like it's probably in our best interest to keep doing this as long as it's working out, so let me forward time again. Zachary and Cassie took some time out to trade fighting techniques. They're both feeling much more capable and confident. Sun's coming up, it will be easier to spot zombies. Casey, Timothy, Zachary, and Isaac attacked a zombie while on patrol. They took care of them using 2 baseball bats, a hardened baseball bat. They struck down 3 of them. And for the most part, it looks like that is everybody in the area. So that was a good patrol from us. There's 1 more zombie all the way down here, but that's not going to be something to worry about too much for now. Okay, so now I think we are... Let me check out their... Timothy's exhausted. Zachary's tired. Cassie's a concussion, minor laceration, and a broken right hand. Alrighty, so it's not looking too good right now. Especially with Timothy being exhausted, I would love him to get some rest, but man, I kind of want to start using the daytime to make ourselves over to the hospital, and I guess we will do that. I haven't checked out the school. I kind of feel like going. Ooh, museum has 10 people. Police station has 24. I'm going to probably jump back to our old location, and then from there we could probably go to the house up here, and then the hospital would be an easier journey as opposed to going to the police station, which has 24 zombies, and the museum, which has 10, right? So, for this turn, we're going to switch everybody to go back to the old homestead. And let's see. We're going to, instead of just checking it out, we're going to breach this area, right? So, we're going to... Supplies? No supplies, huh? Alright, let me go back here. Unsecured. Right. Alrighty. So, let's go back over here. We're gonna, instead of investigate, right here, the investigate option is something that I could switch up. Instead of investigating, I'm gonna hit that. It's gonna bring up this menu. This menu you can see, so it's not a big problem. We're gonna breach the house, obviously, because, you know, unfortunately, I can't just enter the old area. I have to breach it again. So, we'll do that, and we have to take some items with us. So we're gonna take, obviously, baseball bat, hardened baseball bat. I guess we'll take some recoilless handguns as well. And a machete, huh? Weight one. Cricket bat is 2, 2, 3, and 5. 2, 2, 3, and 5. Machete is 3, 3, 5, and 5. Alrighty, so I'm gonna go ahead and take the machete instead. I'm gonna leave one recoilless handgun behind. And one baseball bat behind. I don't need three cricket bats either, man. So you go back, I'll take the machete instead. We'll take one baseball bat, a hardened baseball bat, and a machete and a recoilless gun. Is the baseball bat better than the 3, 2, 5, and 5? 2, 2, yeah. So I'm gonna take the baseball bat instead. So we're gonna go one baseball bat, hardened baseball bat, machete, and recoilless gun. So each one has a weapon. Let's go ahead and grab some 9mm rounds as well. Take about, like, I don't know, take 10 bullets just in case, because we're gonna have to do a little bit of a traveling to two different locations for this. Actually, let me take a few more because the hospital's going to be a little bit packed. But again, we need to leave some room to bring some items back with us. So, let's do that. I'm not going to take any of these tools. Everything of these tools needs to stay down behind. I don't need them right now. We'll take 2 bandages just in case. And that's about it. Cooking ingredients, I think we should be alright for now. So, let's take a devastating flashlight. God damn it. We'll take the devastating flashlight, we'll take the intense flashlight to give us some eyes inside of the area so we don't get, like, you know, basically assaulted by zombies without looking. We'll take the powerful hand axe as well, and maybe even the furious hand axe. And I'm going to take the axes because they could help us kind of breach areas a little bit easier. And I think that's all we do need for now, right? Furious crowbar, let's take the furious crowbar as well. I'm not too crazy about 12.75 out of 19.5. To be honest with you, so let's just take, what can I leave behind? Powerful hand axe. Let's leave the powerful hand axe behind, and we'll just take the furious fire axe. So 11.75 out of 19.5, I guess that'll work out. Alrighty, and let's forward time, and let's make ourselves over there. Oh, is it over here? Okay. Oh, no, no, no. You know what? Nothing happened because they still haven't made it there. There's a zombie. 2 zombies following us, though, apparently. So nothing happened because we didn't make it to the actual location just yet. Again, it's going to be a little bit more of a longer trek, obviously. It's going to forward up time one more time. Timothy, Isaac, Zachary, and Casey approached the house with the intention of breaking in. They had to spend some time trying to find a way in, increasing the risk of confrontation. They headed to a small second-story window leading to the first bathroom. It took no time at all to get inside, using the furious fire axe and the group brought along. There were no zombies inside the first bathroom. It sounds like there are only a handful of zombies wandering around in here. A large mob is gathering outside of the house, and that's actually really worrisome. There is quite a big mob outside, and it sucks because this is a place that we used to actually hold down before, and I guess it's been overrun. That's really upsetting. I guess it's the reason why you leave traps, maybe, huh? Alright, so we're gonna have to, obviously, combat these guys. Hopefully Cassie survives it because she is a little bit jacked up after all. Timothy, Isaac, Zachary, and Cassie were still trying to clear the house of the one remaining zombie. A large mob has gathered outside the place. Most of the fighting took place in the first bathroom. Isaac bashed the zombie's head with a hardened baseball bat. They got them all. And even the mob. So that's good. How's Cassie doing? My lord, Cassie looks like even worse and worse each time I look at her. Hungry, tired. Oh, a lot of them are hungry. That's not gonna be too good for us. Concussion, minor lacerations, and broken right hand. The hunger's what's actually worrying me about over here a little bit. Did we leave any ingredients? We did, but we can't really make much with only one ingredient, I would imagine. So we're gonna have to kind of press on for now. So all of you guys are gonna have to... We've been here before, I think. No, we haven't. But there's only no zombies in there, apparently. So for now, we're gonna go... straight up to the hospital. That's 24 zombies inside. I'm not too happy about that, but... especially with Cassie being, like, one less capable fighter right now. Oh, my lord. Alright, we're gonna try it. Let's see how this ends up for us. Let's see. So, we're gonna... investigate, we're gonna actually breach. Yeah, we're gonna have to breach. Or maybe an assault. Cassie's accurate and Timothy will attack zombies and around the hospital before entering, before heading back. Without entering. No, we wanna enter. Alrighty, so we're gonna do a breach. I'm not too happy about it, but... it's gonna have to happen. So, here we go. We're not gonna make it there in this hour. We're obviously gonna have to skip 1 hour before that actually happens, though. Because it's gonna be a little bit of a walk over there. Oh no, they actually made it in! Alright, Timothy, Isaac, Zachary, and Cassie approached the hospital with the intention of breaking in. It was an easy place to access to, so they didn't have to spend too much time finding a way inside. Zombies in the background, will you please shut up? I'm trying to record here and trying to talk to the people. They headed to a small second-story window leading to the women's ward. Once they got closer, it proved tricky to access. We cleared the room, taking down one zombie. However, there's a bashing down the door, and we're completely surrounded. A large mob is gathering outside the hospital. It's starting to rain, it'll be harder to move around, and our visibility is limited, but at least the rain will dampen the noise from the house. Ooh-wee, look at all the zombies starting to roam around this house. 26 zombies outside, inside. I'll be honest with you, I don't really see us surviving this. That was probably a bad part of my sight, but you know, I apparently wanted to save Casey and... Oh lord. Oh lord, their struggle for survival has come to an end. That's not good, let's view the statistics really quickly here. Ah, man. Shouldn't have done it, man. I shouldn't have fucking done it. Well, I just want you guys to know that we all died because of Casey. So we died for her sins, in a sense. Total zombies in town, 377. Time survived, 2 days, 5 hours. Largest stay was at a house at 4 Pinnacle Road. Relationship, positive interactions, 349. Negative, 213. Snide remarks, 0. Conspiracy, 0. Friendly moments, 1. Arguments and thoughts, 0. Health, we had 2 survivors being infected. Oh, man. Two people got infected. Well, I guess that was probably Joe and Cassie, right? Combat, we killed 37 zombies, and our average accuracy was 64.39. Total fights, 42. Let's read the final entries, though, huh? Let's find out what happened exactly. Where did it all go wrong? Well, Timothy, Isaac, and Zachary, and Casey were still trying to clear out the remaining zombies inside the hospital. A large mob had gathered outside of the place. I think that's what screwed us up, the large mob outside. All the fighting took place in a women's ward. Timothy had killed after... Timothy was killed after 8 zombies mutilated and crushed him. Oof. Isaac was killed after 5 zombies gored him, bashed him in the head, and smashed his hand. Zachary was killed after 7 zombies trampled and gored him. Cassie was killed after 1 zombie crushed her. I mean, she was a little bit injured, so you know, it happens. Alrighty, and there you go. That's a damn shame. Well, we tried. We survived, you know what, 3 nights, or 2 nights after we were released. And a lot of people were saying, like, oh, good luck if you make it through 1 night. And we did at the very least, so hey... I think that we could take this as a learning experience because this is kind of like my most successful run to date. So I kind of like learned a bit more. So we'll kind of go from that. Hopefully you guys did enjoy this run. I'm going to continue recording today, so I'm going to start up a new run. And again, just bear with me for now with the whole drop-down menu. I'll try to get that fixed in the future. And hopefully with another recorder it fixes. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the episode. If you did, I encourage you to leave a like. The support really does mean a lot. And if you want to see more Zafehouse Diaries, let me know. Keep letting me know. Keep letting me know through the likes and the comments, and I'll continue going it. Instead of making a mini-series, you can make it a long series, perhaps. We'll see. As long as you guys are enjoying it, because I'm enjoying playing it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. I'll catch you guys next time.